In today's video, I am going to explain anatomy and function of levator scapula. Levator scapula is this muscle. I am going to explain its origin, insertion, and function. Let me talk about its origin first. Origin is here. This is cervical spine, particularly transverse processes. Transverse process of C1 through C4. Basically, it's from upper cervical spines. Okay, this is origin, right here. This is on lateral part of cervical spines. Yes, lateral part. Please remember, I will talk about its function later, and this thing is gonna be important. Lateral part. Transverse processes of C1 through C4. This is origin. What about insertion? Insertion is here, this part, this bony angle, this part is superior angle. Superior angle, it's right here. And it attaches to slightly your medial part. What about this part? This is medial border. Main insertion is superior angle, right here, this blue color place, and partially fiber attaches to medial border right here. So you can say this is kind of broad insertion. Okay, origin, transverse processes of C1 through C4, insertion, superior angle, and partially medial border. Now let me talk about its function. Levator scapula can move both scapula and cervical spine. So let me talk about movement of scapula first. Okay, this is levator scapula. When this muscle contracts, this contraction brings scapula upward and slightly diagonal way. What is this movement? This is elevation. Elevation is kind of doing shrink movement. Bring scapula to upward. This is elevation. That is why this muscle is called levator scapula. Levator, elevation. Simple, right? Then, orientation of levator scapula is not completely vertical. It's running like slightly diagonal way. Thus, this diagonal vector brings scapula slightly diagonal way. It brings scapula to a little bit this way. What is this movement? This is downward rotation. Downward rotation. Oh my gosh. This movement is freaking important for scapular movement and shoulder movement. Let me explain that real quick. When you move scapula and shoulder, they need to move together. They need to move simultaneously. So when you want to move shoulder kind of this way, scapula needs to go to this way. This yellow direction is upward rotation. So when levator scapula gets tight, scapula is brought to downward rotation position. Thus, you cannot do upward rotation. Thus, you cannot do shoulder abduction. You cannot move shoulder very well if your levator scapula is tight. You got it? Is it simple? Levator scapula brings scapula to downward rotation. Thus, you cannot move scapula to upward rotation. Thus, you cannot do shoulder abduction. That is why flexibility of levator scapula is important for shoulder movement. Very, very important. Anyhow, function of levator scapula is elevation, shrinking movement, plus downward rotation. They are so important. Well, these two movements are movement for scapula. Since levator scapula attaches to cervical spines, this can move neck. Let me explain that. Alright, when levator scapula contracts this way, that contraction brings neck to this direction. What is this? This is side bend. side bend for same side. Same side in anatomical terminology is ipsilateral. Ipsilateral, okay? Same direction side bend. This is when one side levator scapula contracts. How about when both sides of levator scapula contracts? This contraction brings neck to extension. Extension, okay? Both side contraction brings neck to extension. One side contraction brings neck to side bend. Why side bend? Think about its origin. Origin of levator scapula is transverse processes. Transverse process is on lateral part. It's on side part, lateral part, outside. Then this contraction brings neck to side bend. It's very easy to memorize, right? Once you memorize where the location is, it's simple to memorize its function. Now, this muscle is freaking important for tight shoulder. I mean shoulder around this area. You have that, right? Tight shoulder right here. Why? Because we tend to shrink our scapula this way. Why? Because we use smartphone, we use tablet, we look on computer, we look for TV. Then tendency is we kind of bring scapula upward, then head forward position. This position tightens up levator scapula. Thus, we have tightness around this area. Additionally, there's one big muscle above levator scapula. What is this? This is trapezius. Trapezius is above levator scapula. Function of trapezius are similar for levator scapula. That elevates scapula, that extends cervical spine. So their functions are kind of identical. When you look smartphone, when you look TV, when you look computer, trapezius and levator scapula contracts too much. Too much contraction is not good for our body. This too much contraction creates tight shoulder and shoulder pain around here. That is why levator scapula and trapezius are freaking important muscles for stiff shoulder. Oh my gosh, I cannot emphasize enough these two muscles. They are so, so important. Anyway, in today's video, I explained basic anatomy and function of levator scapula. This muscle can move both scapula and cervical spines. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.